Welcome to a lesson on an alternative method for subtracting mixed numbers when an exchange is required. Let's begin by reviewing the two most common methods that are taught to subtract mixed numbers. Let's consider 6 2/3 minus 2 4/5. The first step is to determine the least common denominator, which is the least common multiple of 3 5, which is 15. So the first step is to rewrite both fractions as equivalent fractions with the denominator of 15. For 2/3, we multiply the numerator and denominator by 5. And for 4/5, we multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. This gives us the equivalent difference, 6 10/15 minus 2 12/15. At this point, we recognize we cannot subtract 12/15 from 10/15, and therefore, we need to perform an exchange with the 6. We think of 6 as 5 plus 1, where 1 is equal to 15/15. And then we add the 15/15 to 10/15, giving us 5 25/15. And now we subtract, giving us a difference of 3 13/15. Another common method for subtracting mixed numbers is to convert to improper fractions, where once we have 6 10/15 minus 2 12/15, we convert both mixed numbers to improper fractions, and then subtract, and then convert the improper fraction back into a mixed number. Both of these methods are fairly involved, and therefore, let's take a look at a new method called the compensation method. The idea behind the compensation method is that it's much easier to subtract a whole number rather than a mixed number. The first step in the compensation method is still to obtain a common denominator, hopefully the least common denominator, which again we already know is equal to 15. The second step is to add a proper fraction to the subtrahend to make a whole number. So here the subtrahend is 2 12/15. Notice how if we add 3/15, we would have 2 15/15, which is equal to 2 + 1 or 3. So for step 2, we will now add 3/15 to the subtrahend. And notice how the next step is to add the same fraction from step 2 to the minuend. So if we add 3/15 to the subtrahend, and we want an equivalent difference, we must also add 3/15 to the minuend. So again, looking at the subtrahend, 2 12/15 plus 3/15 is 2 15/15, or 3. And if we add 3/15 to the minuend, we have 6 10/15 plus 3/15, which equals 6 13/15. Now notice we have a mixed number minus a whole number, which makes the subtraction much easier. Because 6 minus 3 is equal to 3, the difference is 3 13/15. This is the method of compensation to subtract mixed numbers. Let's look at a second example. Let's consider 6 1/3 minus 3 3/4. Again, the first step is to obtain a common denominator, hopefully the least common denominator, which in this case is 12. For 1/3, we multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. And for 3/4, we multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. This gives us 6 4/12. Minus 3 9/12. Now we recognize in order to perform this subtraction, we would need to perform an exchange. Instead of performing an exchange though, we will use the method of compensation, which means now we ask, what will we add to 3 9/12 to make this a whole number? Well, because 9/12 plus 3/12 is equal to 1, and 3 + 1 is equal to 4, if we add 3/12 to the subtrahend, we will then be able to subtract 4 rather than 3 9/12. But if we add 3/12 to the subtrahend, we must also add 3/12 to the minuend. And 6 4/12 plus 3/12 is 6 7/12. And now we subtract. Because 6 minus 4 is equal to 2, the difference is 2 7/12. But again, just remember, the compensation method is only required when an exchange is required to perform the subtraction. For example, in this difference here, notice how once we obtain the common denominator, because we can subtract 10/15 from 12/15, we don't need to use the compensation method. We just subtract the fractions and subtract the whole numbers, giving us a difference of 4 2/15. I hope you found this helpful.